Committee Week in Review. I'm Riley Hirschberger.
And I'm Libby Kearns, reporting to you. We will report to you four different stories across the world.
Our first story today is about a Pakistani family killed after the dad refused to let his daughter marry. The potential husband is accused of shooting and killing the family of 10. The aunt, uncle, and 8 children were killed after the uncle refused to let him marry his daughter.
Next, we have a story about ISIS releasing more than 200 Yazidis. ISIS overtook their town last summer and captured them. Most people that were released were women or children. The rest were ill or elderly. There is no reason that led up to this release, but we are looking for more information.
For the third story we have is about chocolate. Some of the world's largest candy manufacturers believe that we could run out of chocolate if we do not act soon. According to the experts, the issue is because of a decline in the production of its main ingredient, cocoa. With India and China rapidly gaining a taste for chocolate, not much can be done at first. Therefore, the only thing we can do to ensure a steady supply of chocolate is to increase cocoa production. So what exactly does that mean? The only way to restore cocoa production is to provide farmers with new disease-free plant varieties.
Finally, we come down to the last story. Two Australian men were caught trying to smuggle drugs into Indonesia. The sentence for this crime is death by a firing squad. Australia is trying to negotiate with Indonesia to get the two men back. The president of Indonesia has not changed his mind and still plans to execute the two men. That brings us to the question of the week. What do you think should happen to the two men arrested in Indonesia? Go to email and the following link for the question.
Now with the results from last week's question, an overwhelming majority of you, 83%, feel that women should be allowed to fight in combat.
That wraps up this week in review